Hi guys, I hope everyone is doing good. Firstly, a very happy new year to everyone, and thank you so much for all your valuable comments. It really means a lot to me, and I'm really glad that I'm able to help you all. In this video, I'm going to give you some very useful tips that is going to definitely help you guys in speaking task, especially third and fourth part. As you all know that we will be receiving a picture and we have to describe the picture in our own way by giving our viewpoints, and it has to be really casual. So that is what they are expecting from us. So this is what is all about in session 3 and 4. So only if we know the vocabularies that is going to be in the picture, we will be able to describe the picture very well. So that is what I am going to help you all with. So in this series of videos that I'm going to post in the near future, it is definitely going to help you guys with session 3 and 4 of your speaking exam. And say for example, in this particular example I have taken children's park. So here, whenever we get a picture something like this, we will have to describe each and everything that is present in the picture. Each and everything that is present in the picture is nothing but vocabulary. So only if we know the name, we will be able to describe the picture effectively. So that is what I am going to help you with. I will take one specific concept and what all vocabularies will be there. I am going to help you out with that only, guys. So first we are going to see each and every picture, and this is nothing but slide. Obviously many of you will be knowing many of the things, but still it will be a revision for you, and for those who don't know, they will definitely learn from this. This is slide and this is swing. Especially grown-up kids and toddlers can play in this swing. And this is known as baby swing. In the previous video, we have seen a toddler swing, and this is called as baby swing because babies can't balance themselves right. So this is specially for babies. And then we can see a seesaw in almost every park. Just in case if you get some picture like this, you can say I can see a seesaw in which two kids are playing they are playing and they look really excited, something like that. And this is called as spring rider. I will repeat, it's called as spring rider because as you see, there is a spring at the bottom and this rider looks like a horse and it is in red color. So how you can describe is, I can see there is a red color horse like spring rider. So this much details is definitely help us, guys. And similarly, this is called as frog spring rider because it looks like a frog. So this is how we have to be giving very specific details along with the description. And this is very commonly, you know, we can see this game very commonly in the parks here. This game is called as tic-tac-toe. Again, I will repeat, tic-tac-toe game. And this is called as sandbox. In a specific area, we can see there is a separate box kind of thing, and it has more sand. It looks like a beach sand where kids can play with dump truck, they can play sand castle. This is known as sandbox. And this is known as merry-go-round. Kids will stand on this and spin around, right? So this is called as merry-go-round. And this one is very common, and every kids like playing this game. This is called as hopscotch. Again, I will repeat, this is called as hopscotch. So now you know the vocabulary of this game. And this is called as monkey bars. This is specially for school going kids and the grown up kids. So they like playing with this bars, right? This is called as monkey bars. And this is also similar to monkey bars only, but the only difference is it looks like ring. We can call it as monkey bars. And this one is really important, guys, because this is very special here. During summer season, they will switch this on. This is called as splash pad. Again, I will repeat, splash pad. And this is where kids can play in water, and they will be very much excited, and they can enjoy like anything here. This is called as splash pad. And this is the overall picture of the playground, and we can see there are many slides, we can see swings, we can see bars, we can see tic-tac-toe game. And this is the overall park, and at the ground we can see there are many wood chips, because just in case if kids fall down, they will not get hurt much if they fall in wood chips. So that is why here in the park they will put many wood chips on the ground. And I'm planning to upload many videos like this, guys. I hope this will be really helpful for you guys. And as I mentioned in my speaking tips video, right, session 3 and 4 is very simple, and this is going to be really easy, because literally we get the answer in our hand. We just have to see it and describe it in a very casual way, and for that we should be aware of all the things or the items that are displayed in the picture. That is very important, because that is known as vocabulary. Only if we have very good knowledge on those vocabulary, we will be able to describe the picture effectively. So in this series of videos, I will definitely help you all with the vocabularies that is going to help you with this session 3 and 4 of your speaking exam, guys. And once again, thank you so much for all your valuable comments. It really means a lot to me. I'm really glad that I'm able to help you all, and I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, take care, stay safe, and once again, Happy New Year. Bye. Thank you so much.